and shall call his name Emmanuel. Flip to chapter 9, Isaiah chapter 9, from verse 6. For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of this government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm just reading this one as intro. Our main text is taken from John chapter 3 and verse 16. John chapter 3 and verse 16. The words of Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Everybody, let's read John 16 together. One, two, go. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Okay, everybody, please, I'm begging you in the name of Jesus. Today is a special Sunday. Today is our Christmas Sunday. Please, everybody, let's join and let's read it together. John 3:16. One, two, go. Hallelujah. Thank God for the children. They are doing well. I didn't hear the voice of the adults. Everybody read that. If you don't know it, open to, there's nothing there. Open to your Bible. Today you may be able to cram John 3:16. It is a plus. Open it. There's no shame in it. You have been born again 35 years ago. You cannot put John 3:16. It's not a shame. Open your Bible and read it. But everybody must read it before I can preach. Now open John chapter 3 and verse 16. One, two, go. Everybody want to go. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Only the choir, read it loud. Hey, look up. Choir, start again. Look at me. Read. Hallelujah. Children, read. Want to go. Hallelujah. People on this column, want to read. People on this side, let's go. One, two, three. You are too fast. You are too fast. Let's take it easy, easy. When we are reading in public, we want everybody to join. We want everybody to go at a pace. Everybody can cope. That's excellent. It shows that you know it. But let's go slowly now. One, two, go. So love the world. Okay, let's take from the last column now. One, two, go. This is wonderful. Wow. John 3:16. This is our message for Christmas. Hallelujah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Ladies and gentlemen, a Christmas message. Hallelujah. Amen. We title it The Purpose of Christmas. In this purpose of Christmas, I will share it with you four fundamental pillars for Christmas. How many fundamental pillars? Four fundamental pillars. Pillar number one, the greatest love. Pillar number two, the greatest sacrifice. Pillar number three, the greatest offer. And pillar number four, the greatest gift. God so loved us. God so loved us. I want you to be honest. I want you to be sincere. I want you to be open to what I'm about to share with you. I don't care how bad things have been with you. I don't care how sick your body has been. I don't care how frustrated your life has been. I don't know how many enemies you have or how challenged things have been with you. But the truth is, this morning, there is hope for everyone that will open their heart to receive God's word in the name of Jesus Christ. There is hope for somebody in this meeting. And I want to believe that that person is you. Hallelujah. I want to believe that that person is you. I want to believe that that person is you. I want to believe that that person is in church. God has a plan for you. God has a plan for somebody. Now, after that Adam has committed sin, Satan took over the reign of the earth by the reason of the obedience of Adam to him. And he was reigning, sin reigned, ruled over the earth. The earth was corrupted, frustrated, depressed. Everything was subjugated. And then people were stagnated, degraded, and embarrassed. But the truth is, God created the heaven and the earth. But the earth was under the oppression of Satan. Hallelujah. Number one, the greatest what? Love. The greatest love. The greatest love. The greatest love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. The greatest love. It was the love of God. It was the love of God. Hallelujah. It is by the love of God that we are not consumed. The love of God. He sent his only begotten Son. Hallelujah. The love of God is universal. God didn't die for Christians. Jesus died for everybody, including the Hindu, including the Pagan, including the Juju priest. In fact, we were all sinners. Christ died for us. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 5, verse 8. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. The greatest love. He loved us and he died for us. The Bible says, the writer of the book of Romans, Romans from 35 to 36, what then can separate us from the love of God? Is it men? Is it angels? Is it hardship? Is it frustration? Is it life? What can separate us from the love of God? While you didn't know God, he sent his only begotten Son to die for you. What can separate us from the love of God? He said, neither height, nor depth, nor men, or angels that can separate us from the love of God. The love of God is universal. He died for people in Ukraine. He died for people in Australia. He died for people in Nigeria. He died for people in South Africa. He died for every human being on the earth. The love of God. The love of God. You know, the Bible tells us that God is love. Hallelujah. 1 John chapter 4 verse 8. He said, God is what? Love. It was the love of God. Because I asked myself, what about Christmas?
What are they celebrating, brother? We are not celebrating a newborn baby. We are celebrating the love of God. The love that God so loved us and did not allow us to perish, and He created a way for our salvation to bring us to eternal life, to bring us to the position where we will share in His glory with Him.
Thank God for Christmas. Thank God for those of you who are still carrying pictures of newborn baby. Jesus is not a newborn baby in a manger right now. He is not. What are we celebrating in the manger? We are celebrating nothing about the manger. We are just reminding ourselves of how God humbled Himself and decided to be born in the stuff where the animals were. It shows the humility of God. The love of God abounds.
Brother, can you ever sit down for one day and think of it? What did I do? You may not understand biology. You may not understand chemistry. You may not understand biochemistry. But you breathe in air and breathe out air. How do I consume the food? I take rice in, and then my body extracts what it needs. And you go to the toilet and poo-poo. You don't need to understand how it works, but it shows that God loves you.
Hallelujah.
It shows that there's a metabolism. There's something happening in your system that when you ate indomie, you did not go to the toilet and poo-poo indomie. There's a process that takes place inside your body, which God has arranged.
Hallelujah. Long before the foundation of the earth were laid. I want us to be conscious of the fact. Touch your chest and say, God loves me. Say it as if somebody wants to be jealous. You say, God loves me. I know that God loves me. Say it like a spoiled child. I know that my Father loves me. Hallelujah. Amen. So what about Christmas? Christmas is about the love of God. Hallelujah. God is love. Universal. He didn't say for only white men. No. He didn't say for only black men. No. He didn't say for only short men. He didn't say for only tall men. Jesus died for how many people? Everybody. Hello.
Somebody say, what of those Chinese that they are using incense? It doesn't matter. Even the juju priest, even the Shongo priest, even the Amadioha priest,
Jesus was born for everybody. Am I talking in church? Because at that time, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 8, it says, you were once darkness. At that time, we were all darkness. There was no light in us. Jesus died for darkness. Jesus was born for darkness. For all humanity that was bound to perish. We're serving Satan. No light was in us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Sir, the love of God is unconditional. Somebody say unconditional. Say it as if you went to school. Unconditional. He didn't say when you sacrifice one little goat. He didn't say when you put 5,000 in your offering. He didn't say when you come and bow down to me in the television. Unconditional. Jesus died for you. Jesus loved you. God sent you salvation. Anyhow. Somebody say unconditional. He died. He sent His Son to die for you. God died for us. Unconditional. Sir, there are different kinds of love. There's the love. You know, English word, each time I read this, the English word doesn't have enough vocabularies. That's why sometimes some of these things is so difficult to explain. Bible says, for God so loved the world. Now, He could not explain the kind of love. So love is showing the intensity, the depth of God's love unto us. Oh, what a love. So deep, so profound. Ephesians chapter 3, 17 to 19. The Bible says, to teach us the height, the depth, the breadth, and the width of God's love. How deep? You know, when we're in primary school, they taught us that how deep and wide. Who can measure it? Nobody can measure it. The depth of God's love towards us is so deep that no man can measure it. It's so wide that nobody can notice it. It's so tall that you can never reach out to cover it. So deep that you may know the depth, the breadth, the length of God's love towards you. Somebody say unconditional. Now, there are different kinds of love. There's a love in Greek, we call it Eros, E-R-O-S. That is the sexual love between a man and a woman, Eros. That's not the love God has for us. There's another love, they call it Filio, F-I-L-E-O. That is just familiar love, familiarity. You see some people with Jesus and Jesus, it's just a love of familiarity. That person is my friend. But this love of God is called agape, the unconditional. Whether you have only one leg or one eye, or you tall like Mugupa, or you short like Tom Tom, it does not matter whether you are black or white or a mongoloid or wherever from any country. God loves us. Unconditional love. He said that man in head too big, God loves him. He said this one in eye too red, God loves him. This one short, he short like Mr. Shorty, God loves him. This one talk, he talk like criminal, God loves him. Unconditional love. God loves us irrespective of what we didn't have, irrespective of what we have, irrespective of where we have been, whether you've been to school or you have not been to school, whether you can speak English or you cannot speak English. God loves you. Anyhow, God loves you. You are a mumu in school, you don't know how to read and write. God loves you. You know how to speak English. In fact, you speak English more than Queen Elizabeth. God loves you. The love of God. How tender. How tender God's love. We need to understand this love to be able to make progress with God. God's love is multidimensional. Somebody say multidimensional. Say it one more time, multidimensional. God loves you in your prosperity. God loves you concerning your health. God loves you concerning your home. God loves you concerning your marriage. God loves you concerning your physical being. God loves you concerning your religiosity. God loves us in everything. The love of God is multidimensional. I want us to understand this. So we said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Now, if you look at that and you try to remove some words from there and you say, God only son perish everlasting life, you have the word gospel. Gospel is taken from that. John 3:16, gospel. God's only son perish everlasting life. Gospel. The love of God is multidimensional. So you don't need to be afraid. Are you hurting? Are you guilty? Are you afraid? You know the psalm is Psalm 139. He said, Lord, even if I go down to the pit, you know me. You know my upstanding. You know my down sitting. You know what I do. You know what I cannot do. But God said, in anything you do, I still love you. May the love of God stand for you this Christmas. Not just for this Christmas, but always. In the name of Jesus. If not for the love that God has for humanity, there will not have been any Christmas. God has love for humanity and planned and arranged our salvation. He sent Jesus. So the newborn babe of Christmas is a product of God's love. Hallelujah. Number two, the greatest sacrifice. The greatest sacrifice.
God so loved the world, what did he do?
Hello.
For God so loved the world, what's the next word there?
He sent his only begotten son.
God wanted to make a sacrifice.
He didn't send one pastor from one village. He didn't send one apostle. He didn't send one professor.
He did not even send an angel.
He brought himself.
God, Jesus. The same with the Godhead. Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, came as a propitiation, as a sacrifice to die for our sin.
This is the greatest sacrifice. Jesus was God, so God died for you.
God died for you. God died to set you free. God died to redeem you from pain, frustration, depression, oppression, and the works of Satan in your life, stagnation, degradation. God died. God had to die for you.
So Christmas is not just about celebrating one small boy that was born in a manger among the animals. It's celebrating that God came to the world, that God came to die in exchange for my sin, for your sin, for our sin.
2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21. The Bible says, he that knew no sin, he became sin, that you might become the righteousness of God in him. He became sin. You know, the Bible has said this, for Romans 6, 23, the wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The wages of sin, man has sinned. Man has forgotten God, has sinned. And the penalty for sin was death, eternal death. But God said, no, I will go collect their death. I will give them my life. The greatest sacrifice. God took your place. On the cross, he took your place. On the cross, he died for you. On the cross, he shed the blood. On the cross, he set you free. The greatest sacrifice. Sir, what can you ever do for this God? How will you ever be able to appreciate this God? He took your place on the cross. Oh God, heaven is a perfect place. No sinner is allowed to enter there. God knew it. And he needed to change your nomenclature. He needed to change your identity from being a sinner condemned to hell to being a saint qualified for heaven. The greatest sacrifice was made to change your identity. Jesus came. Jesus came to change your identity. Jesus came to change your identity. The Son of God became the Son of Man so that men might become the sons of God. The greatest love, the greatest sacrifice. Why didn't God even sacrifice antelopes or mosquitoes? Or elephants, or cow. Because man has committed the forbidden. It was only the blood of God that could set us free. Ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you this moment that God has done for us what no man would have done. And because, you know, we talk about the love of God, Lamentations chapter 3, 22. He said, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy is renewed every morning. Every day, the mercy of God is renewed. It was the mercy of God that acknowledged you not to go to the grave, not to go to hell, not to die without knowledge. It was the mercy of God. And God has brought you this far. Can somebody shout hallelujah? He has brought you this far to save your life. He has brought you this far to keep you. He has brought you this far to give you an evidence to stay alive. By the blood of the Lamb, you are alive today in the name of Jesus. Jesus is called the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. 1 Timothy 6:15. Jesus is the one that stood between us and death and collected our debt, became the Son of Man, was killed by unjust men so that we can be qualified to call God our Father. Hallelujah. Number three, the greatest offer. Now, you know, it's the end of the year, you turn to your TV, you are going to hear, this is the promotion, Airtel, MTN, bank self, they are doing promotion, everybody is doing promotion. The greatest offer. God gave us the greatest offer. Whosoever will. Whosoever. Doesn't matter where you were before. Whosoever. What country you come from. What you have done. You keep 10 people every week to use their head for pepper soup. Whosoever. 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 How many people did Jesus die for? Whosoever will care to receive him. Whosoever. Whosoever. The greatest offer. Whosoever. It didn't say only children below the age of 12. It didn't say only adults from Nigeria. It didn't say not black people are not allowed. He died for every human being on the surface of the earth. The greatest offer. He didn't say those that have had money and they have handled 1 million in their account. Jesus died for how many people? Everybody. He opened the door to how many people? Everybody. He called everybody. Whosoever. Yes. Come. Salvation is available. We're celebrating Christmas because Christmas brought about the greatest offer. Without Jesus stepping into the world as a human being, there will never be an offer. Hallelujah. You know, many people have been going to church, but they have never known the God of the church. The wages of sin is what? Death. But the gift of God is what? Eternal life. So Jesus didn't just die to take us to heaven. That's the difference between eternal life and heaven. A lot of people read Bible, they don't have understanding. Now, heaven happens when you die at the second coming of Jesus. But you know what? Eternal life starts from the day you give your life to Christ. Hallelujah. When people are crying for you, you will never have need to cry for anything. You live your life on earth as if you're already in heaven, satisfied, complete in every dimension of life. You don't have need for shoes. You have shoes to choose from. You don't have need for money. You have money thinking of how to spend. You don't have need for anything. God supplies all of your needs according to his riches in glory. May you start to live eternal life while you are on earth here in the name of Jesus Christ. There's an offer on the cards. You can pick it and you can walk into it. Whosoever. Native doctor, juju priest, Hindu, American, Indian, where you come from does not matter. Jesus was offered for all men, all tribes and tongues. Jesus was offered, Acts chapter 10 verse 35. He was offered for all men of all tribes, of all tongues. Jesus was offered. So you must not understand the free gift of God, the Holy Son of God. He was offered as a free gift, and he was offered as Christmas. So every time we talk about Christmas, we remember the free gift, the Son of God that was offered to take away our pain and our frustrations. May your sorrows come to an end in the name of Jesus Christ. By the free gift of Jesus,
May your tears dry up in the name of Jesus Christ. May you have an opportunity to receive this Jesus into your heart. Number four, the greatest gift. Hallelujah. The greatest gift is Jesus Christ. The greatest gift. Prepare him room. Romans chapter 10, 9 and 10. So if you believe in your heart that God sent Jesus into this world, and you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, they say you shall be saved. There's a gift. You know, if I give you something, it depends on you to collect it or not to collect it. Jesus has been given to us as a free gift. And so many people have rejected him. So many people have said many things about him. A lot of people have said, yes, I know Jesus. But they have never allowed Jesus to reign in their lives. They have never allowed Jesus to walk in them, to be in them, to help them through very tight situations and frustrations of life. They have never given him room to operate in their lives. Let this free gift walk in your life from today in the name of Jesus. Give him room in your heart. Let him say, if you can confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you believe it in your heart that God sent him to set you free from sin, he said, you shall be saved. He didn't ask you to cook and take to any bus stop. He didn't ask you to wear any color of clothes and be able to stand by the riverside. He didn't ask you for anything, just to believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. That's all. He takes over your life. He begins to run it for you. He begins to cause the lines to fall in place and places. A lot of people go to church and are complaining that God is not answering your prayer. Have you confessed with your mouth that Jesus is Lord? Do you believe in your heart? Well, that's the only condition. There's no other condition than that. A lot of people say they were born again in 1944. They have never confessed with their mouth that Jesus is Lord. They have never believed in their heart. They go to church. They don't know what the church is for. They have Bibles. They don't read it. They don't practice it. That is not how God operates. Let Jesus come into your heart. Let Jesus reign in your life. Let Jesus have his way concerning you and concerning the things that concern you. Let Jesus have his way. Be honest, today is a new day. Sir, this year will soon end. Do you like your life the way you are right now? Do you like the pains, the anguish, the tears? How do you want to end this year? How do you want to enter next year? To take all the luggages, to take all the pains into next year? To take all the frustrations into next year again? I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you accept the free offer of Jesus Christ and make your life worth the while. We receive Jesus into our lives, there's no solution. We can go around the circle. You can go around the circle, borrow money from everywhere, until Jesus becomes the master of your life, there's no solution. You can sing with the voice of a parrot. You can dance better than anything on earth. Until Jesus becomes the Lord of your life, you have nothing. This morning, I want to accept the free gift of God and enter into a new level with God. I want to accept the free gift. I want to accept God as my Lord and Master. Please come and hear, come and meet me here. I want to pray with you specially. I want to accept the free gift of God. I have tried my best to make it. It has not worked. I have done what I knew was right, but it just didn't work. But now I yield myself to walk with you, my God. Come and meet me. I want to pray for you a very special prayer. It's a Christmas day. Let the name of the Lord be praised. Let the glory of the Lord fill the atmosphere. Yes, Lord Jesus.
Nearer, my God, to thee. Nearer to thee. Even though it be a cross that raises me.
You want me to pray with you? You want your life to find a new leaf? You want to have a testimony of what God can do? Just come and meet me here. The free gift of God. Something is changing and somebody is going to a higher level today. Please come on, come out quickly so that we can tidy this thing up. It doesn't matter if anybody is looking at you. It doesn't even matter. What matters is that you are moved from ordinary human being to living eternal life. That's what it means.
Every step that I take.
That is what it means.
To the
you want to join them? Come on quickly, it's a new day. What a day. What a Christmas gift. What a Christmas gift this is. What a Christmas gift this is. The Lord has done it all in You want the free gift of God, come and join now. I will round up, I'm closing now. You need this free gift, come and share the free gift and enter into eternal life. Eternal life, eternal life. The life of God on the earth. The life of God on the earth. The life of God. Of your two hands to heaven. Repeat after me, say, Lord Jesus. Say it loud and clear, Lord Jesus, come into my life. This time to steal. Come into my life and steal. Come into my life and reign. Come into my life and rule. Jesus, come into my life and take charge of my life. From this day, it's no longer I that liveth, but Jesus Christ that lives in me. All my mistakes of life ceases today. I walk into your righteousness and your holiness. Take me in your hand. Blot out the darkness of my yesterday. Blot out the blackness of my past. Loose me into a new life. A new life for you, Jesus. To live with you. To walk with you. To show forth your praise in everything I do. Thank you, Lord, for hearing this prayer. In Jesus' name I pray. Go ahead, pray for yourself for 1 minute, then I will round it up. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Father, remove the names of these ones from the book of death and put their name in the book of life. In the name of Jesus, whatever the area that the enemy had a foothold in their life, right now, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, the effect of the enemy's hand in their life is dissolved and dissolved forever, never to show up anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. I set them free from the bondages and the cleavages of sin in the name of Jesus. I loose them into the freedom of the Almighty. Father, they have received your free gift. May this free gift begin to have an expression in their lives, in their vocation, in their businesses, in the things that they do, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we trust you, O God, that we begin to have testimonies of your blessings, of your free gift, testimonies of your great love in the lives of these people, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for this that you have done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's clap for them, please. You can go back to your seat. Congratulations. Congratulations. It's a new chapter altogether. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody stand up. I want to pray for everybody in church. Let me pray for everybody in the church. Lift up your two hands above your head. Do you want the new year to be great to you? Do you want the glory of God to be revealed in your life? Do you want the lines to fall to you in pleasant places? I didn't hear your answer. Lift up your hands above your head. Father, in the name of Jesus, the God of the heavens, the God of the earth, the maker of life, the creator of everything, Father, show yourself in the lives of your children, in the name of Jesus Christ. In this last week of year 2023, Father, launch these people, these men, these women, these boys, these girls, these children, launch their feet on the rock to stay, in the name of Jesus. Give them an unspeakable blessing, the blessing that no single word shall be able to quantify it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, O God, anoint their feet with butter and anoint their head with oil, and let their head stand up like that of the unicorn, far above their fellow men. In the name of Jesus Christ, I release your blessings upon them. Receive God's blessings now in the name of Jesus. Receive the blessings of favor now in the name of Jesus. Receive the blessings of protection now in the name of Jesus. Receive the blessing of grace now in the name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed. 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 Your head is exalted like that of a unicorn. Every shame the devil has wanted to come to your way, by this prayer, those shame is diverted and returned back to sender. The enemy wanted to make you beg for food. I say, you will never beg for food. Your God shall supply all of your needs. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will be a sharer and a distributor of blessings from this day forward in the name of Jesus Christ. If anybody here is sick in his body, I command that sickness. I say, die now in the name of Jesus. Receive healing for your body from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, make our Christmas sweet. Supply what we need to eat, what we need to drink, what we need to wear. And let the name of the Lord be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Somebody rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Our God is a good God.